13 years after its release, Avatar is still the highest grossing film of all time. And now its sequel is set to break more records.
Director James Cameron has 4 Avatar sequels on the way, with Kiwi actors featuring across the franchise. Te Rauhiringa Brown got a sneak peek.
So what does her heartbeat sound like?
Mighty. A visual masterpiece 13 years in the making. Set more than a decade after the first film, the sequel introduces us to a new clan. Its chief, played by Aotearoa's very own Cliff Curtis.
We cannot let you bring your war here.
We are the reef people, we're part of the ocean. The Sully clan, they're seeking refuge, and so we embrace them and have to teach them how to live in the ocean.
I'm from the Matakaina clan, and my character is a free diver. He's a bit of a warrior.
Come on, and you got a crew? Tell us a bit about your crew.
Yeah, so I got a couple of boys around me.
They're rolling in the ocean and going on all these wild adventures together.
Yeah, we got our own kind of side story going on, you know?
Where water connects all things.
Known for his parts in Shorty Street and Duck Rockers, this is Dwan Evans' Hollywood debut.
I heard that you got to see a glimpse of the film today.
Yeah.
What's it like seeing yourself like that?
I wanted to swear when I first saw everything.
It's kind of like so overwhelming because you're like watching it.
You don't even know what to see. Everything.
And it's like the brain is just trying to take it all in because there's so much going on. It's so amazing. It's like it looks so real. It feels so real, and it's so magical.
The film is a first of its kind, using underwater motion capture to create groundbreaking visual effects.
We had to, number one, train the actors in breath hold diving, make them feel comfortable in those situations. And then we needed to tackle the technical challenge. And we quickly learned that no one system could capture both above the surface and below the surface.
We have these machines that with jets on that we have to dive in the water and hold onto it, and it's pulling us under the water with the camera, and we're holding things, and yeah, it's like holding on to like a horse underwater.
Look, you have to kind of get up on the chair like this and balance while hunting and fishing. Yeah.
What was that experience like, and how many kina can you get now?
Yeah.
Too many now.
Too many. So how long can you hold your breath for?
I'd say I could just do 2 minutes now.
I don't know. I'd have to. We can hold our breaths together and see who lasts the longest. But I don't know, I haven't had to do it in a while, but that was amazing because we could, within a couple of sessions, we could do it past 2-3 minutes, yeah. So that was the average. We had to get to an average of a 3-minute hold to be able to work underwater.
This is our home!
Avatar, The Way of Water focuses on the resilience of indigenous people and was inspired by cultures from around the world.
We have a responsibility as storytellers to open people's eyes and let them celebrate the diversity that exists on Earth and hopefully inspire them to collectively find ways of protecting those cultures from disappearing, from a language disappearing, from traditions disappearing.
Remembering that we are part of nature, that we are not just here to exploit nature. So I think that's a big part of the story that we're telling, that we're a part of the family of nature here.
And Avatar, The Way of Water will be in theatres from December 15th.